Hello, how are you?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. While there's a lot of hype around The Last of Us, quite rightly, you also have another project in post-production, Eddie and Sonic, based on the book by Stacey Cochran. This is a bit of a two-part question. How does this project, does that project differ from your previous work, and have you actually read the book yet?
Yeah, job, and it differs than, I was adamant about finding something where I just played a guy with a human guy with a problem, and just who encounters obstacles and just has a healthy fear of death, you know, because Ghost Rider doesn't have any of that, Terminator definitely doesn't have any of that, so I just wanted to play a man with a family who just problems. And so my team over at Management 360, my management company, they were handling that, and they sent me the script, and I read it, and I liked it, and they offered me the role, and I was happy to take it, because at the time, we were in the middle of, I accepted it in November of 2018, and they were working pre-production, we were about to go in March, and of course, the world stopped. Italy at that time was really the place we were counting. We were going to shoot in Rome, and originally Belize was the other location. But at the time, Italy was a hot spot. That was COVID, epicenter of COVID. And so we really don't really not want Italy to shoot right now. We got to go shoot, we got to figure out what's going to happen with the world. And as time progressed, Los Angeles became the epicenter of COVID. And Italy didn't want us over there. Like, why would we want to bring you guys in here? You guys are away from us at this point. And so, but we finally figured it out. I got my work visa. We did a month and a half shoot in Rome, and we did another month shoot in Guatemala. We eventually were designated for the other location. I just got a cut of the film. I think they're still finalizing some stuff. We've held it for a long time just because most festivals were virtual, and I think they wanted to have a full experience. In a way great story. Joanna Vanderham, wonderful Scottish actress, played my wife in the film, and she's of course in the war with she's actually doing a show right now with my good friend Ian, another beautiful Scot that I love. Ian, he played up six, of course, maybe this year. But don't really have a timeline on that film, but it is close to my heart. It's a really deep story about family, and I hope it's I just revert to my stage training experience, I think. You know, because when you're on stage and your lights are as bright as they are and you're staring out into this black void, you just, you have to build the world. You have to see the landscape, see the environment, and stretch your imagination in that way, and that's exactly what you do. And then it's falling to you, and obviously I don't have no focus. To maintain the physical energy and the vibration you need in those moments when you don't have the stimulus is a technique in and of itself. And I think that like I said, I just refer to just stay with them on stage. That's a lot.
Edward Water?
Yeah. Hi.
Oh.
You now basically are part of two of the biggest franchises in the world, MCU and Terminator.
Mm-hmm.
How does that feel to you personally? And is there another franchise you want to be part of?
Yeah. The Ghost Rider Marvel world is so massive and so beloved, and handled it in such a really fun way that world is just continuing to run parallel with